what inspired you to go into meteorology and atmospheric science?
Well, I was in fifth grade when the May 31st, 1985 tornado outbreak devastated western Pennsylvania. I grew up around Harrisburg, and we weren't in the heart of the tornado zone, but it was close enough to make headlines, and we had just studied weather in my fifth grade class, and I was inspired to read a lot about tornadoes and nasty weather, and one book led to another and another and another, and eventually went to school to get a bachelor's degree in meteorology, and then after that a master's degree and PhD, and here I am now essentially studying tornadoes.
So the tornadoes then is your main research area of interest, severe weather.
Yeah, so I study tornadoes and their parent thunderstorms using observations and theory and numerical models, computer simulations that is, how tornadoes form, how they behave, and ultimately the work we hope can make warnings better.
Well, your research obviously has huge impacts on society because it involves saving lives.
Yes, so the discoveries that we make in my research group here at Penn State ultimately improve predictions of tornadoes, short-term warnings, and even sometimes outlooks on timescales of several hours, maybe potentially a day or more. For example, one of the things we found is that there are markers in the environments of storms that might make tornadoes that can give us a better clue as to whether they actually will make tornadoes or not. These are markers that you can't actually see in radar imagery, so that when you combine this information with what the radar shows, you actually can get a better prediction than if you were only using the Doppler radar. Some might say, and I would agree with this, that I have one of the coolest jobs in the world, and that every day I come to work and essentially sit at a desk and get paid to figure out how tornadoes work and get to share that knowledge with students and the rest of society. It's really quite an honor.